Now, the discussion about the open defecation, as well as the use of septic tanks, the dislodging of its contents, as well as health implications, will not go away. There's also the discussion about government building off-site treatment plants. That discussion will also not go away. Then the question begs, what options do we have as a people? There are few people who are advocating for the use of biogas. Should that be where we should go? Let us know what you think. Send us your views and comments, because that's what we are discussing right now. I've been joined in studio by Daniel Osebunsu. He's the vice president of the Biogas Association of Ghana. Good morning.
Good morning.
Great to have you join us.
It's a pleasure to be here too.
All right. So what does it mean to move away from the use of septic tanks to maybe looking at biogas? And what is wrong with septic tanks?
Well, thank you for giving us the opportunity. We've always tried to acknowledge the sponsors who gave us, funded us to do this advocacy. Mm-hmm. It's BUSAC with their funding partners, Danida, and USAID. Mm-hmm. So they are very interested in this issue.
Okay.
And they have given us a broad advocacy program. Mm-hmm. This is the media engagement part of it.
So why should we be interested?
Well, look, mm-hmm. as we sit here, mm-hmm. we talk about immune system to boost this COVID-19 situation. Mm-hmm. The immune systems are directly linked to our health, and our health issues are directly linked to our waste treatment or waste management practices. Mm-hmm. If I told you that we're not on top of our waste treatment, both solid and liquid, mm-hmm. but in this case, we're just looking at just one intervention, mm-hmm. the septic tanks.
Okay.
If I told you that we as an association through the donors, the research, have found out that the septic tanks are contributing to the massive open defecation issue, then the narrative is changing, because then you get to understand why we need to do that.
But how do I link people, you know, using the septic tanks to people defecating outside? Like, how do I link? How is that link?
Beautiful. The decent people, mm-hmm. we can't just go sit on the gutter.
Okay.
So the direct, what we see with the gutter guys and then the beach guys, okay. we see it as to be the real open defecation. But when you have a septic tank in your house, what we call the manhole, it's not your fault. But you keep it for 2, 3, 4, 5 years. And then you call in the cesspool emptier, the toilet pullers. And then they come and pull it. The question is, do you know where they take it to? Mm-hmm. Granted, if you come to realize through our research that mm-hmm. they were supposed to take it to a final waste disposal plant mm-hmm. or treatment plant mm-hmm. within the vicinity or in the region or mm-hmm. district. Mm-hmm. Then you realize that the treatment plants have all broken down. So the question comes back. So where are our toilets going?
Mm-hmm. But there are discussions of government building, you know, an off-site treatment plant. That should be, you know, an option.
Oh, yeah. I mean, off-site treatment plants mm-hmm. is not the issue we are talking about here. Okay. We could even have a biodigester farm as okay. the off-site treatment plant.
Okay.
What we are saying is, why wait and pile your toilets and your biodegradable waste at home? Mm-hmm. Let somebody spend mm-hmm. money to come and take it. Mm-hmm. Have the opportunity to decide whether mm-hmm. he wants to take it to a treatment plant or throw it into the sea or into a gutter or a stream or somebody's backyard. Mm-hmm. Why give that option?
Okay, so what's our option?
Let's nip it at the backyard.
Okay.
At least.
So let's talk about the biogas now.
Yeah, the biodigester.
The biodigester. How does it work?
It's a very simple, low-tech system mm-hmm. that Biogas Association of Ghana is promoting.
Okay.
You have to build it. It's locally built. Everything about it is locally built, just like the manhole.
Okay.
This time around, When you have that in place of the manhole or the septic tank, you are not going to be dislodging your waste because the digester doesn't pile the waste. It rather decomposes the waste and treats it at the back of your facility.
Okay.
And mind you, I'm not just talking about homes.
Okay. Offices. Home,
food processing companies, okay. Market waste, schools, hospitals, public toilets. Just think about where we are stocking our waste.
No, but I know that some people use fecal matter. Others use food waste. So is it a combination of the two?
Combination.
Okay.
It just has to be anything that can rot. Minus plastics and bottles and stones.
Okay, so it's built like a septic tank.
Yes.
But this time it's a digester.
Great.
And so it treats the fecal matter and all the food waste.
It chews it up and you are free of that cost of bringing somebody in again.
To come and dislodge.
To dislodge it.
Okay.
The beauty is that you still get a renewable energy gas from it for the fact that the waste is being treated at the backyard. And you could use it to cook.
Okay, so you can connect it to your cylinder in your kitchen.
No, your stove straight away.
Your stove straight away.
Straight away.
Okay.
And cook with it.
Okay.
And it's renewable because every day you put waste, you get gas enough to
cook. It's not risky.
At all. Mm. In fact, as we speak, the biogas goes out anyway. But you don't build the septic tanks to capture it. So there is no risk. In fact, this is what the association is promoting.
Okay, so what does it take for one to own a biodigester?
Yes.
Okay.
For new people who are building, get this assurance. The cost you spend in building just the manholes or the septic tanks in your house is the same money you use to build a digester, a biodigester. So don't let people even start thinking that it's so good and that it has to cost extra.
Yeah, because there are concerns that it's expensive.
No way. It's a misconception.
Okay.
Talk to the Biogas Association of Ghana. We are collaborating with the ministries to do this. But my point is, the cost is not an issue. In fact, we could even do it cheaper than the septic tanks because the septic tanks, after you've spent money to make it, you'll be spending, money afterwards, paying money to trucks to come in.
Dislodge.
And then polluting the environment and opidificating big time.
Okay. So if you fix one for me, how long will it last me?
It lasts forever. And therefore, quality assurance and control issues comes in. That's why we want the face of the Biogas Association to be the one rolling out this project. It shouldn't just be left to people, because there is a vacuum and there is an opportunity.
Okay, so there are professionals who do that.
Oh, yes, that's
so
the association.
We'll come to that, but I want to know the range. You know, I don't know how much it costs to put together a septic tank, but if you can give us like maybe a figure of how much it costs to build a biogas.
We are rolling and promoting biodigesters at household levels from 4,000, 5,000 onwards. Ghana City spec.
Okay. Depending on what?
Exactly. Depending on your location, the nature of your area. But look, people are spending 10,000, 12,000
on
your septic tank. So it's not an issue, of course. It's a conversation.
And the fact that you get to even get renewable gas from it.
Exactly. But you see, we are trying to compare it at the same level. Okay. Should you not even be getting the gas and the fertilizer that comes out of it, and we bring it to the same as septic tank level. Were you expecting anything from a septic tank?
No.
At that level, you should do a biodigester.
Okay.
And the compelling reason that we are talking about is the extensions to the pollution of the environment.
Yeah, but there are concerns that you are advocating for a national plan or a national,
policy change.
Policy change.
Yes.
For bio
digesters to replace septic tanks. Systems.
Are we ready as a nation for, because I mean, if you're talking about individual levels, I mean, there'll be individuals who say, okay, I'm putting up my building, I want to use a biodigester. But for a national plan, are we ready as a country?
We have been ready some like 60 years ago. Prempeh College, Achimota, even Flagstaff, Jubilee House is running on biodigester. It's all over. It's just that we haven't put a national agenda to it.
Okay.
And probably the absence of an association like what we're talking about to spearhead it. I mean, a government cannot do much if there are no actors.
Mm-hmm.
We are putting ourselves now as professionals, and we are ready.
So if there was a national policy on the use of biodigesters, how will it work? Would there be like a directive for all homes to use biodigesters, or government is going to say that, you know what, every household, this is how we're going? How does it work?
It works on the district levels.
Okay.
If you take your project for permitting or listen, they just ensure that if you were not doing a biodigester, you have, if you are not doing a biodigester, they make you have a biodigester in place of the septic tank that you were going to do anyway.
Okay.
That's the first thing.
Okay.
That would take about 60% of the issue out.
Mm-hmm.
The next one will be those who have already done the septic tanks. What do they do?
Mm-hmm.
That one, the trucks that are taking it, we would put them into a very good use.
Mm-hmm.
They could now take old ones if the people don't want to rebuild their septic tanks.
Mm-hmm.
And then they'll continue using it. Then they will bring the waste to a biodigester plant, typical to the one that has been made at Collegon or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
It's just one or two of them for the whole Accra. It's not enough. What about inland, Kumasi, Sunyani, Tamale? What do they do with their waste?
Mm.
When we talk about it, people say, oh, but we have a plant. That is Accra. And even that one, it's not enough. Mm. Where is the rest of the toilets and then the biodegradable stuff going?
Mm.
So the national plan would be rolled at district levels. Our members are on all district levels.
Okay.
And we are going to train and build capacity of the youth, empower the youth to learn this simple trick and technology that our grandfathers and mothers were using.
Mm-hmm.
Don't throw your biodegradable waste away.
Okay. So this will solve our waste management problems.
Big time.
So if you say waste, what waste are we looking at? Are we looking at
biodegradable waste?
Okay, so give me an example.
See, in your waste in the house,
okay,
60 to 70% of your waste we call boiler is biodegradable.
It's so I want to know
the food leftover.
Yes.
The
so I don't end up putting sachet water in my
at all. Why should we do that?
Yes, so that's why I want you to clarify.
Let me bring you home.
Okay.
In that your waste,
and
you see, I'm not talking about toilet alone.
Okay.
So as for your toilet, you flush.
Mm-hmm.
So you don't have access to it. It goes straight in the pipe and it will go into the biodigester.
Mm-hmm.
Cool. Your boiler or your solid waste, 60% plus is pills, food leftovers, blah, blah, blah. Please, just a little separation at home.
Mm-hmm.
Take your biodegradable waste and you put it into the digester.
Okay.
If you were being, you were paying by the quantity of waste you were generating, and then the rest of the 60% is plastics and stones and even leaves can all go into the biodigester.
Okay.
Your moon grass and everything. You see.
Okay.
How much waste do you think you would generate in your house if you were taking all those things? Plastics you can recycle.
Yes.
Bottles you can. So when the guy comes to come and pick waste, what would you give him?
Because you've segregated your waste, by the way.
Now, if you segregate and you don't understand what to do with the putrefied site.
Okay.
What you haven't done anything. This is why we are coming in.
Okay.
So again, have you start seeing the savings you might make? And then...
So you don't have to pay the rubbish guy who comes.
Why is he coming for it, la?
Because there's nothing to come for.
At all.
So if I have a septic tank, you can redesign it into a biodigester. Is that what you're saying?
Yes, but it depends on how you built your septic tank. If you built it well, we have a way to convert it.
Okay.
But if it's that bad and it's already, you know, when people build septic tanks, they even fear to go around that area.
Why?
They didn't build it well and they think it might cave in.
Okay.
Uh-huh. So if it has been built well, we have the know-how to convert it.
Okay.
But if not, we can still make a digester beside it, and maybe you just use the old septic tank as something else.
Okay.
But then you have...
But if you build a digester by it, won't you just find a way to channel the fecal matter into that digester?
Yes.
From the septic tank.
Oh, yeah, you can do all that. Yeah. And so when you talked about cost,
yes,
I was trying to bring your mind to it, depending on the situation. Mm-hmm. But that shouldn't be the determining factor at all.
Okay.
We are talking about the guy who did not get waste from you so as to go and build landfills, mm-hmm, and create problems for the government to spend over $300 million every year, mm-hmm, on waste issues and still get waste-related diseases. Mm-hmm. Can you understand the dimensions?
Mm-hmm.
And we are even talking about homes. So, mm-hmm, we are just talking about home.
Mm-hmm.
How about, I'm touching my mic. Mm-hmm. How about the schools?
Okay.
How about the abattoirs?
Mm.
How about the degradable waste from the market?
Mm-hmm.
The food processing companies, their waste.
Mm. Where does it go?
Chuck all of these things on the landfill. Mm. How long would your landfill last?
Last.
Mm. Do you now understand the implications of the nationalness of the... of this intervention?
Absolutely.
It's big.
I agree. Daniel Osei Bonso is the vice president of the Biogas Association of Ghana. I wish we had a lot of time to discuss
this. Please find
this.
More time. You know?
So, I mean, they are advocating, I'm talking about the Biogas Association of Ghana, they are advocating for a national policy the use of biodigesters. We should move away from the use of septic tanks because the issue of dislodging health implications. And also, if you use your biodigester, how it's going to help you to get renewable gas. You don't have to spend money and buy gas. It's also going to solve our waste management problems. And they're also advocating that if you must, you know, employ the services of someone to build a biodigester for you, you need to come to the Biogas Association of Ghana because there are quacks around who will not do a good job.